Okay, so I've re-added the material pool because I wanted to do images, but like I'm trying to figure out like chicken and egg kind of deal between like, do I want to implement materials first and work back down to images, or do images first and work up the materials? I'd rather move top down from material pool down to what else we need. So I have the material pool initializing and deinitializing. Now I need to be able to actually update the material pool to update materials. Because let's have a little look here. Material and material pool. Now, right now, I only have the ability to create, find, load, and unload. Not really. On top of that, because right now everything's going through the material pool, which is kind of suspect. Well, not really great. So what I want to do instead, or try anyways, for material loading, since materials are going to be typically created, they'll be like declared in a file, like I am using material, and then each material will have a separate file, which will then actually define it. Much like I have already kind of have for this, except it wouldn't be like this. It'd be like a material which includes a fragment descriptor. And then it will also include like albedo, texture files, or image files, depth, normals, whatever. So after I create and find, rather than load and unload, what I really need is a photographics in export. I need to be able to update material where I can kind of pass in a material. And then, yes, no, maybe. Okay, well, at least I know one thing. I need a faux fragment descriptor. Actually, that's like the only thing right now. So this could actually just be like an independent function. Assuming these were public, which they are not. Because again, how do I instigate the loading of this thing from internally? Right now, I have this, and it goes into a manager, which then goes into a load. I may want to split up the manager from the loader. I think I will later. Okay, so right now, one step at a time. I keep trying to like go deep dive, figuring out how I want to do things before I really am capable of doing them. So we go in, we go to load. Load right now is, what is it? Nothing. Okay, we have a load function, and we'd have an update function. Be a star. Oh, isn't this a whole boatload of fun? I've kind of gotten myself in a little circular dependency here. I really have. Actually, I want three. I want to separate a loader, an update updater class, and a material class. Our file loader. Dang. Because right now, material. Okay. What if we just go down here and just do material? HTTP. Simple. This, we're going to make it similar to this, where we have two sets. Material. There's probably actually more than read material. Okay, yes, there's two things. There's a declaration, and then there's a definition. Okay, so declaration, and then there'll be yeah. And we'll probably want to find material pool. Double point for that. and definition. We won't require the pool because we already have the declared material. Yeah, I can work with this. And I may also want to change it for these guys as well. Well, not this, but maybe shader. As for right now, it's just a declaration, not a definition. But later. Const. Yeah. Okay. Move that over. And open up this guy. Declarations. Okay, so the material declaration is quite simply for the moment a name, I think. So very much like shaders, just very, very, very basic stuff. Since when does adding string to whatever. It really isn't really catching this stuff. Okay, yeah. There's only one type right now. If I add inline types later. until then. Okay. And I can get the file name back out, right? Yeah. So then we'll just quickly do that as well. Basically, why am I doing this manually? Copy and paste. File name. We got node name. No, node name. Okay. Declaration, easy enough. Right? I do have it here. Yes, I can do that before. Actually, I wonder if, okay, I don't know if I do like this way for no name. I mean, it should write it out, but let's be super sure. Because I usually do get things very wrong a lot of the time. Include it. Yeah, it is local for the time being. Use one declared YAML write material declaration. Go. It'll be instant. It'll be material file shader. Really? That equals that, or that equals that. Material doesn't have a substep. Let's do it that way. Yes, it does work that way. Okay, I can do that. So I can actually do the same thing for fragment shader as well. And in fact, I will do that because there's only one type of shader and you only get it from a file right now. No inlines, no nothing. And then we get it from the same node as well. Nice. That's actually something I need to work on is the color blend attachments because there are items that I need to write out for color blend, actually. I'm pretty sure that fragment descriptor. This color blend state info has some other stuff than these guys. It has this blend constants, logic op, enable, and flags. I need to write these guys out before I forget. For fragment descriptor anyways. So I'm actually interested in what it would print out right now. Couple of attachments. Yeah, that's actually something I need to do, especially about these guys. Can I read and write? I'm trying to think if there's a way I can read and write these in an automated fashion as well. So that, like, I can do attachments automatically. Because right now I'm just doing a full conversion of the struct, which straight from where is it? No. I don't even have the type in here. Okay. Okay, I need to find the type then. Give me a fragment descriptor type. Give me this. Copy that. Paste it in right about here. Because right now, if I do this function straight up, it's just going to also copy an attachment count and p attachments. Not really what I want. So I'm going to just like skip these two out. Can I just do like a hash to ignore them? I'm going to need add that to ignore. I'm going to need add an ability to ignore hash ones. I want to keep them there so I can actually know that they're there, but I don't actually want to process them. Line contains star, then ignore the line. Okay. For Vulcan. Okay, structs, txt, do it. Okay, last one, it should be state info, which is, nope. Blend constants is a no-go. Dang. Dang. Okay, ignore that one as well. I'm gonna have to do that manually as well. Right in the, unfortunately. So get all this just the three basic ones. Not really great. Do this, go to the end, paste in the new ones. At the very end, fragment descriptor. Okay, got this, we got that. Okay. If okay, we can slightly rework this equals. Optional, we have a color blend for the node. Color blend SCI. The what was it? The last four was these guys. Blend constants. Ooh, okay. I'm just not going to touch it right now. Okay. For the rest of it, it'll be YAML write. Optional. No, it has to. No, because. The only reason it'll exist is because there's something else in there. So, yeah. Color blend. Nope. Just regular data. We'll just have like a VK global attachment state empty, and I guess default data. Default is just empty data. Yeah. Candidate with function not viable, no conversion from that to end for third argument. And second argument is not no, okay. Sorry, what VK pipeline color blend state create info to that? YAML read optional. Okay, YAML read optional, first of all, up here. Okay, that fixes that. Write optional. Deduced between state and color blend state create info. Oh, yes. Actually, does that mean I could just do this? Okay. It does. Give it a go. It should not create anything because it's empty. But it might. Okay. And let's say if it was dot equals. No, because there's no flags for it. Are there? Vulkan core, we're here. We go to the state create flags. There aren't any. Okay, we'll just say this logic op enable is true. Give that a go, see what comes out. We should then have color blend with logic and op enable being zero, because yes, it's different from the default. Okay. Yes. Either equals true from this, or false, or true from one of these. Then attachments. Okay. We got this, these two, fragment descriptor. Okay. Minor changes. Going back to materials. I did have materials. I was saving it out to that. I got the declaration anyways. I need to do definitions now. The definition is basically this for the moment. It'll load into that. Load definition. Yeah. Okay. So for the moment, it's just the fragment descriptor underneath it. Otherwise, there would also be, it's always going to have a fragment descriptor for one. Otherwise, it'd be the material descriptor. But I don't have anything other than the default. And the single albedo is not implemented yet. So let's just add the one. And call it good at that. I need faux fragment descriptor pool. Catch is very simple. It's just that again. I do already have exceptions. Read a fragment descriptor. From subnode. And for that, we require the fragment descriptor pool and the shader pool. Ooh, my. Really going deep. But yeah, okay. If it fails to read it, the whole thing dies anyways. Technically, this would actually set it, wouldn't it? It'd be like this fragment descriptor equals, or Let's move this back into the public domain for a moment. Are you sure? I don't even need that really. I'm just passing it on. I do need it here. Waiting back to here. Okay, just because it's a double pointer. Actually, that's right. It shouldn't even be a double pointer. It should just be a single pointer. We already have it. We're just updating it. Okay, so we do that. And that's basically the only thing I can think of, really, for the material. Otherwise, yeah, for reading it. We just gotta try writing it. Write fragment descriptor. That and that. Use of undeclared. Identify YAML read fragment descriptor. Yep. Yeah, it should be the opposite way. Third argument. Okay. Okay. So at the moment, material declaration that's going out, and then back in. So we know that that's working. Right now we want to just write, okay, and then new material. P fragment descriptor equals fragment descriptor. Then we want to just write material definition. Right there, it's new material, root node. Absolutely brutal. So then we have a new faux material. New material 2. Okay. We want to read. Whoops. Material definition is from the root. Root node. We've got the shader pool, fragment descriptor. We then have new material too, which we are modifying. You want to make sure that's the same. Okay, new material. blah has. Okay, hold on. Same fragment descriptor. The different manager. That's not right. What happened? Okay, let's see where he loses the manager stuff. So he currently has. He's never set. Okay, but otherwise it's saving and loading it. So I do have the option to save materials and load them now, which also includes the fragment descriptors and the shader declarations. Okay. Just make that minor modification. Let's actually just go back and do it here. which are verbose. Okay. Oh, I needed to add that to that. Not quite there on the materials yet. Okay, fix that up. Okay, so I got kind of materials, kind of saving, loading. Do I want to add work on shaders? Shader definitions might actually be quite useful. Yeah, I guess I probably should. Okay, what do I need for shaders? When I load it, let's see what I get. Okay. I got the code. And for... Well... That goes with the shader. Where shaders should be intrinsically tied with descriptor sets, which are currently in the domain of the material, or not the material. Vertex descriptor? Oh no, is it part of actually the shader? I have a part of this? Yes, I do. And push constant or constant range. I really need to export and import those with the shaders and the built-in set layouts. Okay. Okay. So really all I need is two things, three things. The built-ins, the descriptor set, and push con. Okay. I can't really put that aside because there's nothing else. We need this here. We need the write and to read to, can I write? I don't know if I can write. I'll try. I'll just have it anyways. Definition. We can read and write. We already have a pool, the shader. We can write the shader. Yeah. No, I need the I need the other one, this guy. Oh, not this necessarily this guy, but I need the where he comes from, who he's with. This. When I read it, when I write it, do I need to write it? Ooh, yeah, I may actually require it for writing as well. Because I only have the handle. Yeah, I need it. In fact, I need both of these for writing as well. He could be constant. This will be a bit heavy. Use that as an example. First of all, we get the node. We're trying stuff. So first we have built-in. I guess it would just be built-in, wouldn't it? So if it's non-zero, YAML serialization or a parsing. Just that old bit. I have a clearer idea on how to do this one. I think. Okay. Yeah, okay. Standard vector bk scriptor set layout nonsense. Not these. If there are any, even any, I need to actually. Node start with layout is there anything else that goes into this? There are flags. So, okay. So it'll be similar to the other one where we have, okay, yeah. We have this. Which is only really going to have the set of flags, and that's it. Let's get it. Let's add it in. Okay, now we can add it in. I'll add it up here. Don't want to do that. We don't want to do that quite yet. I'm really going to want it though soon. So we do that. We now have these new ones, which is literally just nothing. No, there it is. It's just the create flags. Now, of course, like this YAML is pretty heavy, but again, like it's not going to be for production. It's for human readable. There'll be a binary version of all of these for production one decade. YAML read optional. Now I go through. Wait, hold on. No, it'd be a sub note. It'll be a sub thing of that, wouldn't it? Yeah, it would have to be, yes. Oh, okay, yeah. I kind of should do that way. Okay. If I need to get the node first. Here and do this stuff if this needs to be outside though, just in case. What's it called? Bindings. If that, then we need to go through, it's like a iterate. Can we just we have this. Just go to the declaration and just what do we got? Type count flags samplers. So we'll get type count flags. And binding. Okay, yeah. Yes. And it'll ignore immutable samplers for the moment. Because it's got a pointer on it. Let's just make it explicit. Ignored. Do it again, more. It grows. This is required because the node exists for a reason. It's this node, though. We add all these, and then at the end, we just say, set layout CI. Okay. Really static cast it. Otherwise, Microsoft's going to complain massively about the narrowing. Explicitly, I know it's been casted, guys. It's okay. Probably not gonna, whatever. Push constant range. Oops. Yet more. Here we go. Even more. This little script is saving me so much time. It ain't even funny. Okay. Okay, we need to get back to this. Okay, we're going to have a node. It'll be a list, so it'll be a multiple. Built-ins. Go to this flags. Or or equals built-in descriptor sets. I need a string to that. Okay. String of a bit. Oh, this is janky. Do the opposite. to and from string. Okay, now that I can go back to shader there. From string of, oh, that is super generic. To built-in set layout, because there's no way there was not going to be a collision on that. To that of built-in name, okay, so at the end of all this, LP shader equals, built-in setlayouts equals new. Shader what was it, layout? Just layout. I need to actually define it. Get and this push const range equals the new push constant range. So we're gonna kind of do the opposite. If I want to be able to do exports, I will need to know how. Yeah, we put on a separate note in this case. Iterator built in. I just want to copy it and then I'm going to slowly iterate it down. I is less than. Number of digits and not equal 0. One time, let's shift it over however many times. That means we have a flag here that we want to put, throw out. So then we want to push back, just to a string. So we can do to string of set flag. It's the other way around, isn't it? I'll figure it out soon. Well, it doesn't really matter which way it goes, does it? No, it actually one shifted over by one, shifted by over by two. Yeah, no, it doesn't really matter. Oh, it does, because otherwise it'd just be shifting into zero all the time. God dang. If it's not blank, then we can put something in. Then we'll add it in. So right node. Was it specifically that? Equals this node. Wonderful. If it's not null, then then I'm not really, I can't really do that. Need to be able to retrieve these things back out. Problem is, it may not necessarily stay there. So I'd actually have to pass both things back out. That's a unique pointer, which is a pain to move around. This is a very rare operation to save a shader definition. Exceedingly rare. If basically never happening. If it was found. Get data. Like should be like get export data. Get construction info. Create info. Get create info. Yes. I'm just going to make my life easier. Just use a vector. Just use a gosh darn vector. Okay. Easy. Clear that out. Don't want to accidentally muck around in there. Otherwise, we return false. Now I need to rework this a little bit, so just leave that as blank. We're just about to fill it up anyways in a second. Copy of this by I. That. Okay. Okay. If not equal that, and then we need these two things. from this. Okay, simple enough. If not that, otherwise we have the information and we want to be able to put it out. So was it the descriptors? At the end of this, we do have layout. It's not null handle. And not equals the dummy one. If it's a dummy one, then yeah, we don't need any of this. But if it's not the dummy one, that means it's something unique, special, new, whatever. We need to get it. So we've got the layout node. Now we need to into the current node. To the default data, which is just blank. CI. Yeah, node, wonderful. Otherwise, we need to go through all the items, the count of items. So we need to go through the binding. Was it bindings, right? Yeah. Maybe the create info was just had flags, which is very unusual, but I suppose it's possible. Can I actually do it on this? I can. Okay, it makes it a little bit easier to read and write these guys. Actually, I'll just quickly. Well, actually, no, it's. Yeah, you're right. Okay, fine. It's not columns. Go away. Because of synchronization. For each of the layout bindings, we're going to add another one. onto this node. We're going to put the data, which is iterator, and it's going to be the binding node. Push back the binding. Okay. And at the end of this, we're going to put all those bindings onto the binding node. Now the binding nodes are all here, so that means just write node. Sorry, not write node, layout node. Equals okay. And then after that, push that back out. That just leaves the const range. Coming up on 2 hours, okay. So 2:30 in the morning, great. Gonna feel it in the morning. It already is. Okay, I'm exhausted. One last thing, one last item. We push this if it's not default. So optional. Push constant range. Default is got data. The right node. Okay, I wonder if I could actually let's try this out. Oh, I don't have anything. I don't think any of these guys actually have no and no. There's no descriptors, layouts, or sets, or anything like that. So it's pretty pointless. Just save it. Okay, we added descriptor set layouts. Struct parsing, shader stuff. Let's actually see if it builds first. Reading shader definition. Really, it didn't. Really? I didn't even need him. Interesting. I'll keep him there for the moment, though, because I'm not entirely convinced. I won't need him soon. Nah, that's bollocks. If I don't need him, I don't need him. Not right now. If I need him, I'll add him back. Need him for the dummy layout though. That messaging and now we get to the shader stuff that we actually just did. Yeah, all that. Push it up. Call it a night. Cheers.